Good evening, once again. Let's see, we are recording. Good evening, once again. You are once welcome to this board. Today marks another day of the training. And today we are about to continue what we ended the last time. We've almost done with the tools, the Photoshop. We are almost done with it. And it's left with a few touches which will be attached to it. We call it a day at the level of learning the uses of all the tools, Photoshop. And a day will come for you people to bring forth your problems so that we will be able to solve that one also. All your views, ways to solve it also. So what we have for today also is how to use the bevels. Sometimes it comes to our friend that someone will bring a shower gel. It's a container in a rounded pipe, but it's not all that a circle. So it's for you to make sure you get the shape of that image, or you get the shape of that container. We do have procedure in doing it. Today we'll be learning on that one. Also, we'll be learning on that after knowing how to use the bevel. We'll also be learning on how to draw that shapes also. So I won't waste much time. We just move to today's topic. And we continue from that sector. I would like to show off my screen now. Then we begin with lesson for today. So I've shared off the screen now, and I'm launching for Photoshop. To begin with today, launching Photoshop, we all know how to launch Photoshop, so I won't talk about that. We all know how to learn Photoshop. We move to where the icon is. If it's on your text bar, you double click. If it's in the Windows sector, you double click. If it's on your screen also, your desktop, you double click also. Okay. Open for Photoshop now. And there are some works which I did earlier on, which is previewing now. So I should wait for that way to be before. Okay, there is no way. So for me to launch forth a page, press on Control N to launch forth, or move to file, and go to view to launch forth a new page. So this one, the preset is already at international, the size is already at A5. And the resolution is also at 300. So that's all. That's okay to launch. So we've launched a new page for the work for today. Launch a new page now. How to use the Google. This is how we use the Google. So I will first give out a background first before using any Google. The sheet. Either you draw a rectangle box to give a background, or maybe you want to give a bigger background, move to the tools, content, click on gradient tool, and draw that one also to give a background. So these tools, you have tools of doing that, is either you draw a rectangle or a sheet to give a background, or you move to the gradient tool, and the gradient tool contains So now move to gradient 2. Click on the gradient 2. Move to the color section. Click on it. I do like this color, so we'll just leave it out. If you want radial gradient, click on it. Then you come to the pitch. They draw this straight line. Go down the mask, draw this straight line. They just leave it. So you leave it, you get to notice that gradient is drawn now on your sheet. Gradient is drawn now on your sheet. So now you use it to attach content. Click on text. Click on your page and type in any words of your choice. Any words of your choice. I like to type in the discipline. So now I will fold this text to the middle. Stretch all the text by holding down the shift of the point to stretch all the text. I press on enter. Then you move straight to the layer content. Double click on the layer content. Of the indiscipline, and you take in the box of this, which is the bevel and the emboss. So click on it to show its property. If you want to increase its size, when increasing it, you see from the text that is changing. And when you decrease the depth, you see the bevel being increasing to the size. Its softness is also there. You can either increase its softness or just leave it out. Then you move to this side. Click on it. You can change it to any style. Maybe I do like this, so just leave it that way. Then you can change this color also to any color. To any color. Hopefully, to realize it. Increase it a little bit. Then increase the size to this. Then you do have the style also, styles. So you click on this to give the style of it. If you want outer, it changes over there. If you want this, it changes over there. If you want blue emboss, and you want stroke. So you go in for emboss type. And person, okay. This the bevel. This the bevel. When I zoom it, you see how the bevel is. You see it looking like a 3D. It's looking like a 3D. So you can change all the color over there. Click, click on this. Anyway, give it this. I give it this color. I give this color. This is the embossed. This is called the embossed. This is the embossed. So we've learned on how to stroke. So let's stroke it to see the embossed here. Click. Tick in the embossed. And click on this. Increase the size. You change the color to any color of your choice. Maybe you for this, or maybe you for this, or this. You for the darker one. This is when you can see the embossed very well. See the embossed very well. So let's go in for another test in this clip. So let's type in. For once. Increase the size of the person and control it to highlight. Then you highlight the size. Use the upper and the down key arrow to increase the size. So this is we move to the layer, double click on it. Then you click on bevel once again. Double click on emboss and bevel again. Then you select for two. And we go for pillow now. Increase the size. Then increase the difference. You can come also here to change style. Change the style. So we're going for this. Then you can also here to change the color. But then also if you just change this color. Or you can go for the one which I choose to have. Go for red. Click on red. Press on enter. You can increase the opacity for it to show clearer. Increase the opacity for it to show clearer. Then you move straight to the stroke content. Click on the stroke. And you click. And you increase its size. So that you see the bevel very well. See how the bevel looks like. Is another bevel, which is the pillow. So this bevel can also be applied to shapes. Maybe I go for it's like going for a circle, not a circle. Go for the picture. Double click on it. Give it a kind of transition like that. Double click on the layer. Click in the box of bevel. Double click on bevel. Increase the size. Then you can over here also change to any style. Change to any style of features. So then you highlight this. The piece is also better. Then I'll click on this to keep it. Different color of this before this. Push up like that. Click in the box of stroke. Then click on stroke. Then increase the stroke. Increase the stroke in it here. Then click on this to select for the writing color, which is this. Push up like that. Apply. Drop shadow again, light drop shadow. Now we are using what you've learned for you to see how the bevel works, or for you to see its clearness. And then click on the shadow, increase the size, increase the spread, So we've applied bevel to this one also. Shapes apply bevel to the shapes, so that's how bevel works. You can also bevel a picture, click on it, and we'll click on this at the down of the bevel. You find out contour, click on contour, and we'll click on it. You increase the size of the contour. Come over here, also change. You can also change to different style. This one is different. You see it's shining very well down the bevel line. Close this, you will see it unless bevel is also attached to it before the contour works. when bevel is not attached to it, contour can never work smooth, can never work anymore. It works or it moves with bevel. It moves with bevel. That's how you go by it. You can see shiny, very, very shiny. The circle looks shiny. Circle looks shiny. That's how bevel works. That's how bevel works. It's very, very simple. That's how the use of bevel. So now we've learned at this top-up bar, we've learned on bevel, length of contour, length of stroke, length of inner shadow, inner glow, a satin. It's also applying color to cut images also. I click on this. You change color while you click. Change the color to the color. Increase the size. This is the size measurements. And you go for the measurements. That's the size measurements. So, also, that's how the something also works. So when you double click on this layer content, the flint strong shadow, flint outer blue, flint part of the left, medium to value, flint, color value starting, flint blue. So we flint everything concerning the sector. Flint everything concerning this sector. Concerning this sector. That's how we do like that format also. That's how we do like that format. And I was saying earlier on that sometimes someone will bring a container. A container which is somehow it's shaped. I never define that the shape content. This shape can never be found. This shape can never be found at the shape content. So it's for me to draw the shape. It's for me to draw shape. This is how we go about it. Let me shift this one to the top of the decrease the size. I want to work on this sheet. Decrease the size. So, this is going to be the position. So now, I want to get an irregular shape. I go in for a circle. Draw the circle at the side. So I want to get the irregular shape. Click on it. So click at this side. Click on it. And move to this. Switch between free transfer and warp boot. So click on it. And shift this one here. Shift this one here. This goes for fun. Fun. The same way we also bring fun when we tell you to get the shape of the fan. Use the wrap doing that. Use the wrap and click. Give it a color of white. Use the wrap. And so duplicate it to the side, and we are getting the color of so that's a go by that format also. And we also have another, you see, and maybe how would I say, going for this shape. Draw this rectangle. Want to get an irregular point on this. Move to one. We should do that also. This is get an irregular shape. This was used to get irregular shapes. We used the wrap to get irregular shapes. That's how we do by the also. That's how we do that also. So I think we are done with learning the tools, how to use stroke, bevel, inner blue, outer blue, shadow, inner shadow, outer shadow, satin, color of the flint, all that. And flint, the marquee, the quick selection, the lasso, coupling, the eraser, the shapes, text, how to apply color, the gradient, the eyedropper in the paint bucket, how to apply, how to apply color using the tools. Reflect fading more, reflect fading more. So, in our next meeting, we will be doing simple design, applying the knowledge obtained from learning the tools to design that. So, we apply the knowledge so far doing that. So let's go on straight to that's how we go by the tools all so we have done it all the tools. So we will do a quick now applying what you want. So we find of what you want so far. So so let's move on to another example of how we apply this to get better understanding. So we'll change this background in terms of this to another background. Okay.